America's Most Wanted. Have you seen this man?
Is here standing outside the United Nations of Benetton, which is where representatives from the three corners of the world come to end wars, international drug trafficking, and everything else that is a bit of a laugh. I is here with the geezer who was the Secretary General of the United Nations. His name be none other than my man, Boutros Ghali. How many countries is in the UN?
If I'm not wrong, according to the last statistics, it must have more than 180 countries.
Is Disneyland a member of the UN?
No, because Disneyland is not an independent state.
Do you think in 100 years' time, Disneyland or Disney World could have a seat?
No. Disneyland is not doing politics. Disneyland is doing...
Well, some of them characters.
It is for the young children.
How many languages is spoken at the UN?
You have practically what we called five languages.
But which is the funniest language? It's French, isn't it?
Not necessary. Maybe Arabic is more funny.
Oh, yeah.
It depends to whom.
To you. What was the one that when the delegate went up and started speaking, you was like, man, I got to go to the phone.
I'm not allowed to do this. I'm the Secretary General.
Yeah, but there must have been one when they were going up there. And you just go, hey.
I have to have a poker face like this.
Do you speak French?
Yes.
How do you say shit in French?
Chic.
Shit. Like crap, rubbish.
Ah. Oh. De la merde.
How do you spell that?
M-E-R-D-E.
M-A-R-D-E. Thanks for that. We want to say big up yourself, Boutros Ghali. Respect.
Here we are in the Security Council chamber.
Wicked.
On the United Nations. This room was donated by the government of Norway.
All right, it's safe. So what happens here?
Here, 15 countries that come from different regions of the world discuss about world peace and security.
Safe. Respect. What's that, Jordan? Ain't it stupid letting one sportsman have his own seat, no matter how, you know, powerful he is?
Well, that is not Michael Jordan, if you're referring to the gentleman. That is the state of Jordan in the Middle East.
Well, that's what you was telling the cameras, but ain't we all equal? Ain't it ridiculous letting one person have the same power as a whole country?
Well, again, it's not the person that is sitting there. It's the government of the state of Jordan from the Middle East.
Is it named after Michael Jordan?
It is not named after Michael Jordan.
Does this country really exist?
Yes, it does.
What's this?
Guinea. It's a country in Africa, the Republic of Guinea.
Is that a real country?
Yeah, it is a real country in Africa. It's quite a large country as well.
With full respect, why do you give crap countries a vote?
Well, that's your opinion of Guinea. That is definitely not shared in this organization.
I was looking around. Where is Africa represented? Don't see it nowhere.
Well, Guinea?
Where? Where's Africa?
This is a country in Africa represented.
So you claim?
This is an earphone used by all of these people that sit here to listen to the meetings in six different languages.
Ain't it dangerous, though, having translators?
Why do you think that? Why do you say that?
Because let's say the translator is a double agent or something like that. He can say, you know, well, dodgy stuff, like apparently the Vietnam's war was started when Saddam Hussein got in a translator role, and he was going to send in an email to the president of Thailand,
and to just ask him for a cup of tea, but the translator role put in something that turned out to like, your mum is a hole and I's Bonda, and the Thai person got well eggy, and then that's what happened. That's how the Vietnam War started, didn't it?
Well, I'm not sure that your recount of the story is correct. It might very well be, but as far
as that is the word on the street.
Okay.
How does you choose who sits next to who?
It goes in English alphabetical order, from A to Z.
Can you swap if the person next to you is really annoying you?
Can you swap? No, I don't think you can. No, the answer to that is no.
What happens, does you ever separate people if they is mucking around? Like if they is chucking stuff at the president, Kofi?
Well, no, that has never happened, as far as I know. So that has not been a necessity, no. At 3 o'clock, there is a meeting taking place here.
In like 10 minutes?
10 minutes, yes. A meeting taking place here to discuss the situation in Iraq.
Can we be in the meeting?
No, you can't.
What about?
We can't, because...
What about just me?
Nobody can. No public is allowed here for security reasons.
So what's going on in Iraq that we should know about?
Okay, Iraq is suspected of producing weapons of mass destruction.
Wicked.
Gas and nuclear weapons.
What a laugh. And where does the boss man sit?
Well, the Secretary General sits right here.
He sit here?
Yes.
Wicked. Can we sit here?
Definitely.
I've just written that Saddam Hussein is a bellend.
Okay.
Yaksimesh, American national sport is called baseballs. It's very similar to our sport, shurik, where we take dogs, shoot them in a field, and then have a party. I like you. I find more now with Team Savannah Sandnets. Dzień dobry.
I love USA! Do you love USA? Yes! I love baseball! Do you love baseballs? I like you! Do you like me? US&A! 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 Yes, yes. And now please, everybody will stand for the national anthem, Kazakhstan, for respect. Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan, Mogul's Robichtar. Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan, Mogul's Robichtar. Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan, Nomogi, Astana. Astana, Almaty. Kula kura tel v'tzele avoda. Kula kura tel v'tzele avoda. Kula kura tel v'tzele avoda. Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan, Mogul's Robichtar. Kazakhstan, Kazakhstan, Mogul's Robichtar.
Did you pay some money to the boss to make sure your side wins?
That is not done in baseball.
But maybe $50.
No.
You want to pay him $50?
No.
I have a 40,000 tampon.
Oh, well.
No applicator. You want to give to the umpire?
I don't think so.
You think he will mind that there is no applicator?
Hello.
Everybody, you want to come together to make a touch one another?
A big picture?
Like yes. Picture? Now we all hug. Yeah. You are a real man. I like. You have a shower? Can I come? You are very strong. You are strong. You have a crumb like my friend. My friend, he have the same crumb from you. Yeah. Can I touch? You want to do a wrestle?
A wrestle?
Yeah.
What's that?
I like to wrestle.
You want me to take you out?
What does it take me out?
You want me to take him out?
What does it do?
I'm gonna pin you.
Yeah.
I'm gonna pin you.
Yeah.
USA. USA, man.
You okay?
Oh man. Dang, man.
I okay? I make a joke. You think I hurt?
Do it! Yeah! Savana!
You win.
I win?
Okay. No sad, happy.
No sad, you
heard. Okay. You win me. Thank you.
No way.
How did you manage to maintain a natural look?
Well, I have a good hairdresser.
What is the philosophy of the show?
It's kind of like trailer park trash.
What it is, trailer trash?
Just kind of like, I guess, like backwoods from like, just like middle of nowhere, kind of poor, dressing what you have around.
Also, they are very primitive, rubbish people.
Kind of, yeah.
So tell me, do you hope that these white trashing people will buy the clothes?
I don't think they can afford it.
They are too poor. It's like, no. We take the clothes from the homeless people,
right,
and we sell them in the shop.
Jack up the price.
And then the homeless people cannot buy them.
Definitely.
Yeah. That is the beauty of fashion.
Yeah.
So how important is fashion to you?
Fashion is very important. It's what keeps us creative. It's what keeps us alive. It's what keeps us inspired. It's what makes us get up and go out of our houses every day. You know what? She's a real fashion icon living in her own time.
I'm from New York, and I come across a lot of people who are not from here, but who are from other parts of the world, who really have absolutely no fashion sense.
They look ridiculous.
There's no personal style.
Why don't you just put them on trains, send them to a camp and say bye-bye?
Yeah. I would love to say bye-bye to most of them.
A lot of the style gurus in Austria are saying Osama bin Laden is like the best dressed guy. Do you think so?
I think he's cool.
He's so cool.
Yeah, I don't know if he's the best dressed guy, but he's definitely very fashionable.
Have you ever thought of using disabled models, like, but with normal clothes? I mean, not like disgusting disabled, not with that kind of, but just like the mentor thing. So you wouldn't really be able to see it.
There was one model that we used for a couple of seasons that was deaf.
How did she know when to go out? Did you have to push her?
No, you just, you know, you tap her.
It's like in Austria, we know as a casting director is more important jobs than, you know, doctors or politicians. Is it the same here?
No, fashion isn't thought of as seriously as the medical profession here. But I think...
That's ridiculous.
I think so.
I mean, fashion saves a lot more lives than doctors.
I think so.
Jetzt bin ich hier mit Michael. I'm here with Michael, the other designer today. Congratulations.
Thank you so much.
Why was there so much cardboard? Why was that theme so much there?
Cardboard? No, there was no cardboard.
But there was a theme of cardboard?
No.
Why did you base the whole show around the theme of cardboard?
Well, because everything is so hippie in fashion that I wanted to do something that was the opposite.
Right.
You know, like stiff and cut and just amazing like that. That's what I really felt like.
Because no one has yet had the guts
to do
a show about cardboard.
No, they don't understand.
They're too scared to touch it.
Yeah, they are.
What I loved about the show was that it had no humor at all, which was just so powerful.
Well, it was dead serious.
Yeah.
Yeah. It was super serious.
How did you keep the show humorous all the way along?
Using pop icons.
Why was the show all about the individual?
Because that's what we are, and that's what we prefer everyone to be.
It's amazing because this show was, at its essence, all about other people. Why?
Because when you're an artist, you look at other people, and that's how you become an artist, is you observe.
I found the collection so heavy that it was pulling me down into a place better than heaven.
Yeah, I wanted it to be like a weight on people. I wanted you to just fall, collapse.
How did you make sure that the show was just so light?
Because we wanted things to flow, but at the same time not just be too overly feminine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But you somehow managed to achieve this sense of the whole show being kind of light as an air, everyone just floating up.
Yeah, that's what it was. They were in the clouds. They were in space.
Do you think consistency is important?
No.
Booyakasha! Diggity, check this out, because I is here with none other than my main man, General Brent Scowcroft. Him was the national security advisor to George Bush, who was the president of America, and also to some geezer called Ford. Is fighting the most harmful thing you can do to the other side? Ain't the most harmful thing you can do is to call them nasty names?
Not really, not for countries.
Let's imagine we was back all those years ago when you was fighting Russia.
Mm-hmm.
If the president had gone over to the head of Russia and said, yo, Boris or whatever, mm-hmm. stop being such a
mm-hmm.
he would have felt this small.
Well, as a matter of fact, we did that.
Did you go, ugh?
Well, not you.
But what?
Well, you don't do that in diplomatic
but
circles.
Did you do a kind of spouse kind of impression?
No.
When should a nation nuke another one?
That's a very good question. That's a very good question. I would say only if it's very vital interests are involved.
Do you think America should nuke Canada?
No.
Why not?
Well, because, first of all, we don't have any real significant problems with Canada.
But if you nuked Canada, the amazing thing would be the element of surprise. Them would never expect it. And then you could take all their, everything they got there.
We don't want what they have.
Well, they must have something good up there.
Well, they have a lot of things good. They have a lot of gold.
And
they have a lot of oil.
Those cow things with the horns.
Moose.
All right. If you is an officer, what is the bestest tactic in battle?
To win.
The best tactic
you can do is to maneuver so that you surprise the enemy.
So is the bestest tactic surprise?
Sure it is.
Because that makes me think of, ooh.
Yes.
Did that surprise you?
Yes.
That did, didn't it?
And when you surprise somebody, you have the advantage because you know what you're doing. And he doesn't. He's not prepared.
That's true, because I was thinking that,
Yeah.
Yo.
Exactly.
Most of the great
generals in history have figured out how to surprise the enemy, do something they don't anticipate.
No. I understand what you're saying, because
Exactly.
Yeah, I was trying to surprise you.
No, and it's exactly that concept.
Is the army worried about the threat of chemical and biological weapons?
Sure.
Did they ever catch the people that sent Tampax through the post?
No, they did not. It wasn't Tampax, it was anthrax.
All right, I think there's different brand names.
Well, it may be, but anthrax is the germ. Tampax is something very different.
We just want to say big up yourself, General Scowcroft. You was helped us out here, and you know the interesting. Ooh! the surprise thing. Yo, the surprise thing.
It.
But we just want to say, all you lot out there, listen to the words of my man, the General. And I ain't shitting you, he really is a General Scowcroft here, because him has said enough important things about warranting. You better listen up. Don't get mashed up. Keep it real. We know you probably can't tell me this because it is classified, but what do the letters CIA actually stand for?
That's easy, Central Intelligence Agency.
Is that your real face?
Yes, had it for a long time.
Let's talk about some conspiracy things. Let's go back to the grassy knoll. Who actually shot JR?
JFK?
Who's he?
I am Boutros Ghali. Put down your gun and listen to
Bob Marley.